VC, what's going on? It's King's Drummer, and it's time for another video where I show you what I bought. It was a good day of vinyl shopping, a good day for vinyl. As I sit here, it is Saturday night, and last night, Friday night, my band played in the town of San Jose, and it was a fun gig. We opened for another band, and it was a fun night all around. It was just really fun. So, but I came home really, really late at night, tired, and just wanted to sleep in, and I did. But when I woke up, it was a beautiful sunny day here in Northern California, and I wasn't planning on vinyl shopping, because for me, vinyl shopping, you have to go to Sacramento. So it was a spontaneous decision to go, because the day was just so beautiful. I thought, beautiful day, beautiful sunny day to go vinyl shopping. Let's go. And off I went and bought some records and got some great stuff. So here we go. Let's check them out. And this is a huge, huge addition to the Genesis collection, because I finally have this on vinyl and it sounds sweet. It is Genesis, We Can't Dance. And We Can't Dance sounds spectacular on vinyl. It's mine at last, and I had to pay a pretty penny for this one, but so worth it, so worth it. I mean, I had to listen to this on cassette and CD since it came out in 1991, and boy, this sounds so much better on vinyl. You could hear the bass notes a lot better. They ring out, and they sound as if they're playing bass right in the room with you. The drums sound so much cleaner, with more depth and attack. And the keyboards just layer over everything so nicely. It is a beautifully mixed album, and it sounds just spectacular on vinyl. Really happy to have this in the Genesis collection now. It's a two-record set. Well, this came out in 91. It had some great songs like No Son of Mine, Jesus He Knows Me, Driving the Last Spike, Never a Time, That's the Way of the World, Hold On My Heart, and of course the best song on this record is Fading Lights, a beautiful, beautiful song, which sounds just so spectacular on here. I can't tell you how great this sounds on vinyl. Just great. Especially the song Dreaming While You Sleep, which is a song about someone driving through the middle of the night on a rainy night in their car. They fall asleep at the wheel. They don't see a young lady about to cross the street, and they end up hitting her. And instead of doing the humane thing about seeing if she's okay, he just drives away. Later, to find out the girl is in the hospital in a coma, and it's on his conscience. The girl is lying there in a hospital in a coma is on his conscience now, and he keeps having bad dreams about her. And it's a dark, very, very dark, eerie song. And to hear it on vinyl through speakers, oh yeah, huge improvement over CD and cassette. Huge. We always know vinyl sounds better than CD, definitely better than cassette, but when you actually hear it for your own ears on one of your favorite records, it is a night and day difference. So really glad this is now in the Genesis collection. Okay, the next record up is one by Marillion, Clutching at Straws, and that's a cool little album cover. Look at that cover, that picture. I like that, that's nice. Kind of same concept here in the back. Really good album. And the songs I'm familiar with, of course, is Warm Wet Circles, Sugar Mice, Incommunicado, The Last Straw, White Russian. I usually listen to the Hogarth era of Marillion the most, but I do have one with Fish on it, who's the original lead singer, and that was Misplaced Childhood. I really love that album, and always loved the song Sugar Mice, and I keep seeing Dwayne Lazarus show this album a couple of times, and really talks of Marillion in highest regard. So And I've always been a Marillion fan, just didn't own this particular album, so we're glad to have it now. And I also have a ticket to see the Marillion concert in June when they come to San Francisco, so I'm going to start loading up on some older Marillion records just to get myself psyched up for the show. But this album seems to be in really good shape, except for this right here on the side here. But it looks great, and it has the original insert with all the words to the songs. And I believe it's a custom label. Yes, I just gotta get that goddamn price tag off it. I hate when my local store puts a price tag right on the label, but here's what it looks like without it. So, pretty cool. Marillion, Collection of Straws, great band. Can't wait to see them in concert in June. That is going to be an amazing show, because it's been a long time since Marillion came to America, so I got my ticket. I am ready to go. Classic album here. This one looks really old, but nonetheless happy to have it. It's by Cream, Disraeli Gears. And this looks like, it really looks like an old copy, but you gotta love Cream. Some classic rock music on this album. And it's on Edco, as you can see. Love me some Eric Clapton. Love me some Cream. And real glad to have this one. Strange Brews on here. The song Sunshine of My Love. Way, way, way back in the day, I was in a cover band. Well, a band that did originals and covers. And we did Sunshine of Your Love as a cover, and oh man, it was fun to play that song. But we did that one, and we did White Room as well. White Room was another great song to play. So I'm real happy to have this album. I like a lot of songs on here. I always loved Cream. Some great music, so real happy to have this in the collection now. This next one's a bootleg from one of my favorite bands, The Police. And here we go. The Police. As you can see, which is written on here, they say the track listing on the record is correct. The label, however, is incorrect. So if you look at this cover, and you look at the writing here, you would think it's a Japanese label, but it is not. It is on a Record Express called In Records. You can see. And it's a bootleg, so. And I haven't listened to this one yet, so I can't say if it sounds fantastic, it sounds crappy, but I love the set list on here. A lot of great early songs from The Police. I think this is probably from 1980, especially that song Next to You. It's So Lonely, I love those two songs together. But this looks like it's going to be a fun album, and Stuart Copeland is right up there, in my opinion, with Phil Collins, as far as drummers that have really influenced me over the years. Stuart Copeland is the master. I mean, he's really the one that got me to notice the drums first. I mean, yeah, it was Phil Collins when I saw him live and made me want to play, but Stuart was the one that got me looking the drummer's way. The way he plays always caught my eye and caught my attention and held it forever. I think he's just an amazing drummer, so having anything live by The Police, because I got some bootleg DVDs of The Police live that was pro shot back in the early years of the band, and his drumming is just that inspiring. So very, very happy to have this bootleg, and I believe it's from 1980. This looked like an interesting album to buy. It was only $2, and I thought, what the hell, it's Fleetwood Mac live. It was only $2, and I do love this era of Fleetwood Mac, and it has a lot of the hits like Dreams and Rhiannon, and what was the other one that I like a lot? If I can see it, oh, Landslide. I really love that song, Landslide. Sarah's really nice. Say You Love Me. Go Your Own Way. It's a cool collection of songs. And let me see if I can fit this gatefold in here so you guys can see it. There we go. If you look at Mick Fleetwood, you can tell that during those years, must have been hell in that band. It looked like it really is taking a toll on him. as well as all of them, because I know they're notorious for partying hard, but they did make some great music and wrote some amazing songs. And this is going to be a fun one to listen to. It's, like I said, it's a 2-record set. And let's see what it's on Warner Brothers. So Fleetwood Mac Live, 2-record set on Warner Brothers. Real happy to have that. You know, Fleetwood Mac, I love them for their harmonies. I love their harmonies. They are a band that can really sing well. And, you know, I want to get into the early years of Fleetwood Mac before, you know, Lindsey Buckingham and joined the band, and Stevie Nicks joined the band. I want to get into those early years of Fleetwood Mac, so that'll be the next little venture of things to discover while on vinyl shopping. This I took a chance on, and it paid off in a big way. This is the first album I have from this artist, and I enjoy it. I enjoy it a lot. It is from Ben Harper, and it is called The Will to Live, the live EP. Supposedly this is a limited edition pressing on 180-gram vinyl, and this collection of live recordings is available for the first time on vinyl. And more of a blues rock player Ben Harper is. I mean, I've heard of him. This is the first thing I ever owned of his music. I don't even know if I get this the right way up. But anyway, I guess it goes like this. Interesting little picture to put on the album label there. But some great music and some good guitar work too. I love the blues rock sound. You know, I'm a so-so fan of blues. I don't have much blues in my collection. I do have some Stevie Vaughan. I do have some Robert Cray. I'm a big fan of Kenny Wayne Shepherd, though I don't have any of his vinyl, but I do have CDs of his. So I do like that sound. And I was listening to this today in a record shop sampling before I bought it. And I really loved what I heard. It was some good music, so real happy to have this in the collection. It may inspire me to buy some more records by Ben Harper if I could find them. So, real cool to have that one. These next two albums are from a group called Happy the Man. And the first one I'm going to show you is called Crafty Hands. As you can see, it's the corner's cut here, so it can be resold at a very cheap price as a used record. Just haven't really listened to this in full yet, but I sampled it in the record shop and listen to side one. Great prog band. I really dig their brand of prog. Really good stuff. I remember one time I went to one of my local record stores, which is called Replay Records, which is now closed. I walked in there and he was listening to Happy the Man on CD, playing it throughout the store. And while I was browsing through the records, I was listening to this wonderful music. And I was in my head, trying to place who this band was, and I couldn't figure it out, and the guy who owned the shop, Willie, told me, well, it's from a prog group called Happy the Man. They came out in the late 70s, and they're awesome. And unfortunately, Willie didn't have any of their albums in his stores. So here we are, this was like almost a year ago, and now I found me some Happy the Man, and as well as their debut, which is self-titled Happy the Man. I'm assuming this is their debut since there's no album title. And I could be wrong because I'm not too knowledgeable about this band's history. But sampled both these records and fantastic. I do like it. I can't wait to listen to it in full. And this is a promotional copy, which you can see where it says right there under this on the playing speed. So this is a promotional copy of Happy the Man's first album. Or at least I think it's their first album because it's self-titled. And so I hope to find more. I don't know how many albums this band has out there total. I've seen a mention. Oh, here's a picture of the guys. You can see what they look like. Happy the Man. I've heard them mentioned time and time again here on the VC by a few of you. And like I said, owner of my last local store before it closed down kind of told me about them, so I'm really happy to have at least two of their albums in my collection. I know I'm going to love this because I'm now sampling both these records I was really enjoying what I was hearing. I could tell I'm gonna really love this music a lot. It's proggy, but it's good progs, and I enjoyed it. So, two records from Happy the Man, and I am happy. All right, terrible joke there. These are some 12-inch. These are some singles, two 12-inch and one 10-inch record that I got that I found interesting. First one is a 10-inch record from Coldplay, The Speed of Sound. And this is on a limited edition pressing. And of course, here's the insert. Nothing too extravagant looking. And it's a limited edition printed on clear vinyl. So on clear vinyl, The Speed of Sound by Coldplay. And on the flip side, we have some songs called Things I Don't Understand and Proof is on the flip side. And this plays in 33 speed, so I was listening today and it sounds fantastic. And the reason I'm not a Coldplay fan, though I do like some of their music. I really like this song because of personal reasons. A few years back when this song was just released, just dropped, I took a trip to Las Vegas with some friends and family during the summer, and besides it being excruciatingly hot out there, I heard this song, Speed of Sound, everywhere I went in Las Vegas. I heard it in the car on the way up there. I heard it in the we stayed at the Luxor Hotel, the big black pyramid that shoots the beam of light in the sky at night. We stayed there, and you know, all throughout the hotel and the house PA, and I think I heard it, because we were there for 3 days, I think I heard it probably five, six times. And then as we're walking the streets of the Strip in Vegas, I hear it there too. I hear it on the speakers right by the Viaggio, where we were watching the fountain show. They had it playing on the speakers there. So I heard that song all throughout my trip in Las Vegas, and so every time I hear The Speed of Sound on the radio, it always reminds me of that great trip we took in Vegas. Spent three beautiful days there, fun days, and good times, and so every time I hear The Speed of Sound, I always crack a smile because it reminds me of a trip to Las Vegas. So when I saw this in the record store, I thought, oh, I gotta get it because of such great memories. I think I like the memories more than I like the song. The song's okay. But the memories that come with it is what makes buying these little knickknacks here extra special. So, Speed of Sound, Coldplay. And a 12-inch single I found for a buck. And it's an A's group. Didn't it work? It's a mistake. 12-inch single. Oh, anyway, this original shrink wrap's coming off. It's a mistake. And on the flip side, we have Who Can It Be Now? And a song called F-19, which is an instrumental song. Really good remix versions of this, as you can see. This is a special remaster edition of both the songs, It's a Mistake and Who Can It Be Now. Love me some 80s music, as we all know. I love 80s cheese to death. And this is definitely 80s cheese. But good 80s cheese, and real happy to have that. I own the albums that both those songs appear on. But I saw that this was a special remastered edition, and thought I'd give it a try. Even though I own the records that those two songs are on, I decided to buy it anyway, and I did hear a difference. It does sound a lot better. So really happy I got it. It was only a buck, and it sounds good, and they're both songs I love from that band. So Minute Work, It's a Mistake, and Who Can It Be Now? All right, another 12-inch single, again from the 80s, Paul Hardcastle. The song is called 19. And the reason the song is called 19 has to do with the average age of every soldier that went into the Vietnam War. The average age was 19, thus the name of the song. And you know, the song reminds me a lot of, it sounds real similar to the band Art of Noise. Kind of has that sound to it. But there's a lot of spoken word samples over the keyboard jam. And it's all based around keyboard, drum machine, and you know, synthesized bass, and real groove, dancey kind of groove. But these spoken word samples are talking about facts about the Vietnam War, and there's an interview of a soldier telling about what he had seen there, and the post-traumatic stress syndrome he deals with when coming home. And that's why I find the song interesting, is because of the subject matter. In my family, it hit very hard because I have an uncle that served in Vietnam. I also have an uncle that served in Korea. I have a cousin who went to Kuwait and was killed. So, my family's been hit pretty hard by wartime, and songs like these really hit close to home. And so the song 19, I remember in the 80s, the video had some great footage of Vietnam footage, old footage, and it was an interesting video. It wasn't just, babes and, and glamour stuff. It gave me something to think about. And it's a good song, and I love the subject matter. So 19 is from Paul Hardcastle. Really interesting song. Real interesting subject matter, so really glad this song was made. Well, that's going to do it, folks. That is my vinyl haul for the Spontaneous Saturday. I've gotten a lot of subscribers recently in the last couple of weeks or so, and I'd like to welcome all of you new people to my channel. I hope you guys are liking the videos. And there's a lot of threads going around. I'm answering the ones I feel like I can do a good job answering. A lot of new members. Their VC is really growing well, and I see, and I've been noticing a lot of members have been meeting up and making videos together, and that's great because I was hoping for big things for the VC in 2012, and it is happening before my very eyes. A lot of members meeting up, making videos together, vibing off each other. You can see the joy in their faces, how happy they are, and because now they got a vinyl buddy that they can actually see face to face, not just an image on a computer screen. It's great to see, and I hope to see lots more of that in the VC, because that's what it's all about. It keeps the community together, keeps us strong. All right, well, that's going to do it for my video, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Take care.